Yo, what's up, content creators? Welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome Saturday. And for some of you guys watching, it's Sunday. Needless to say, I hope you guys are having a great weekend. For today's video, I'm excited to talk to you about one inexpensive piece of filmmaking equipment that will take your B-roll, your shots to the next level. What you guys saw in the introduction was some BTS of a promo video I shot for a very big music producer. And the thing that you guys saw was me using this right here. Now, this guy right here is the RATRIG 14-inch slider. It comes in at about $100, and there's some different options you can get for it to really dial this in and have a lot of really nice, smooth, detailed footage using it. Now, there's a couple things that I'm going to be implementing in my future reviews, and that's going to be price, portability, the construction, and whether or not it gets the job done, and it gets the job done right. Now, these four different things we're going to talk about, and I'm going to give you guys some pro tips on how to use a manual slider, because this is my first slider and I did not want to spend $300 and up on a mechanical electronic one. So with a couple of cool things that I could show you guys, we could really get that perfect cinematic movements using this inexpensive piece of equipment. So let's talk about the price. There's two different versions of the one that I'm using. This is the 14-inch, and then there is a 24-inch. The 14-inch comes in at only $99. The 24-inch is at $125. And for the $25 extra, you can get a nice long slider. I chose to go with the small one for the portability. So starting off the bat, we have a very affordable slider. I know there's ones that are a little bit cheaper, but I don't know how the construction is on those. And this one, I saw my buddy Nelson using it, and I loved it when I tried it. Nelson's also a dope YouTuber. If you guys speak Spanish, he does filmmaking tutorials and reviews. I'll link the description below for his channel, but I saw him using it and I had to pick one up. Now, getting to the portability, the more and more I obtain gear, the more stuff I have to carry. And I have two SKB cases, I have a backpack, and I wanna be able to carry everything in only like one case or one backpack. So the reason why I went with the small version is because it's tiny and it fits everywhere. Now, check this guy out. We have four bearings right underneath. We have both 3/8 and 1/4-20 options. There is a 3/8 attachment on the top, and I do have a 1/4-20 thread attachment right there, so I could put my regular tripod head on it. It's very simple and straightforward. We have a little locking mechanism right here, and it's super smooth. Like, it goes back and forth, and it does what it's supposed to. It's made really well. It's constructed of, I believe, aircraft aluminum, and so far I'm loving it. It works. It gets the job done for my filmmaking needs. When it comes to using sliders, they're very simple to use, and it just takes a little bit of practice. The hardest thing is having a consistent movement throughout the entire push or pull or slide. And there's a couple things we could do to make this easier and effortless. So when you practice, you could use two fingers and you could pull it side by side like I'm showing on the screen right now. But there's another thing we could do, and it's gonna be a lot easier. And I know some of you seasoned filmmakers know about this trick. Now, what you want to do is get yourself a long rubber band. This rubber band right here is for garbage pails. It was like two bucks for a 3-pack at Ace Hardware. And what we could do is we can wrap it around the tripod head and slowly put tension while we're pulling. What that's going to do is have consistent, steady movement throughout the entire motion, and it's gonna look as smooth and cinematic as possible. Now, you could go from pushing to pulling side by side, no matter what, it's gonna look the best. Now, with this specific slider, because it is relatively short, it's gonna look the best using a longer lens. So right now I'm demonstrating using it on the 28-75 Tamron at 75 millimeters, and also the 70-200 G Master. The longer the lens, the more motion it's going to have. So for you guys that have lenses like a 50 mil or like the 16 to 35 or just a wider lens in general, you might want to consider the 24 inch option just because you're going to have a lot more movement in your slide. So let's hop outside and I'll show you how easy it is to get some awesome cinematic movements using this slider. And then I'm going to show you the end version of that promo video so you guys could see the full interview with the producer, Justin Harris. Let's hop outside. Guys could tell there's a lot of different uses for sliders, and I think it's a really good tool to have. So having that little bit extra in your arsenal is going to step up your content that much more. I want to give a special thanks to Oscar and my buddy Chris who helped me shoot the multiple scenes of B-roll that you guys saw in this video. I want to give a thanks to Justin Harris, the producer that I worked with on this interview. And before I let you guys go, if you thought this video was useful, if there was value to it, please leave a thumbs up and a comment below. It really helps out this channel, and I love making this type of content for you guys. So let me get some love in the description. And I want to know, what slider are you guys using? Do you own a slider? I know these movements can be emulated using a gimbal, but because of the bob as you're pulling it, it's never going to be perfectly level. I've tried a million times, and sometimes you nail it, sometimes you don't. You could even do it handheld, but just having that steady momentum and that movement going seamlessly across the screen, it comes out so buttery smooth, and that really shows a lot of production value in your films. So I'm gonna leave you guys off with this interview of the final product from that previous shoot in the beginning of the video, guys. I will see you on the next video. Until then, I'm Jason Anthony. I'm saying peace out. Later.
My name's Justin Harris, also known as Steal My Beats. I'm from Mission Viejo, California, and I'm a music producer, artist. My major influences are really all over the place. I mean, I'll go from listening to Dog Pound, to Korn, to Gorillaz, to Final Fantasy soundtracks. Like, I'm really all over the place. My love for music and my unique sound have brought me in rooms with Daylight, Willie B, Denzel Curry, Hobson, J. Cole, Ninth Wonder, Absol, just to name a few. I just kind of channel painful experiences or different things I've gone through in my life that, you know, make me question, and I try to release those emotions in my beats. I'm Steal My Beats, and don't steal my beats.